What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English Beat. I'm Katia, and in today's lesson, we're going to focus on the proficiency exam by doing a grammar quiz. It's inspired by the book called Common Mistakes at Proficiency and How to Avoid Them. So guys, if you're studying for this exam, I recommend buying this book as it will help you brush up on your grammar and avoid making some common mistakes. You can find the link to this book in the description box. And now grab a piece of paper and a pen and let's kick off. So I'm going to give you 10 sentences with two options. You're going to choose the correct answer, and in the second part of the video, we're going to check the answers together. So the first sentence, I have difficulty A, to park, B, parking. Choose the correct answer, A or B, and write it down. I have difficulty A, to park, or B, parking. Let's move on to our sentence number two. There has been a considerable decrease, A, in, or B, of pollution due to the lockdown. So the same, choose A or B. There has been a considerable decrease, A, in, B, of pollution due to the lockdown. Let's continue our sentence number three is, there are a lot of things you need to take A into, B in account when moving abroad. Choose A or B. Write it down. There are a lot of things you need to take A into, B in account when moving abroad. Number four, the government is going to A, rise, B, raise taxes. Choose the correct answer. The government is going to rise A or B, raise taxes. Let's continue. Number five, I think it'll be difficult to find A, economical, B, economic flights from now on. A or B. I think it'll be difficult to find A, economical, B, economic flights from now on. Number six, my father didn't play a part in my A, upbringing, B, education. My father didn't play a part in my A, upbringing, B, education. Number seven, I have a close A, relation, B, relationship with my mom. Choose A or B. I have a close relation, A or B, relationship with my mom. Number eight, A, how many people are we? Or B, how many of us are there? A, how many people are we? Or B, how many of us are there? Let's continue. Second to last sentence. The company has bought two A, aircraft, or B, aircrafts. Choose A or B. The company has bought two A, aircraft, or B, aircrafts. And the last sentence, you need to stand up A, to, or B, for your beliefs. You need to stand up A, to, or B, for your beliefs. So choose one option. So now I'm going to give you the correct answers. The first sentence, the correct option is B. I have difficulty parking. It's also correct to say I have difficulty in parking. So difficulty doing something or difficulty in doing something. So the verb to have difficulty takes the gerund form. More verbs that are followed by ing are to miss, to mind, to fancy, to avoid, to imagine, to be worth, or a very interesting verb, to envisage. Envisage. It's level C1 and it means to imagine that something might happen in the future and especially something good. For example, I envisage walking around Dublin with my friend in the near future. Our sentence number 2, the correct answer is A. There has been a considerable decrease in pollution due to the lockdown. So after a decrease, we have to use the preposition in, a decrease in something, and the same happens with an increase in something. So remember to use the preposition in and not of. Okay, number 3, the correct answer is A, into. There are a lot of things you need to take into account when moving abroad. We take something into account or into consideration. Number 4, the correct answer is B, to raise. The government is going to raise taxes. So we use to raise here and not to rise, because to raise is a transitive verb, which means that it requires a direct object. So you raise, for example, you raise a child, or you raise your hand or your voice. So you raise something. You need to use a direct object. While the verb to rise is intransitive, which means that you don't need an object after it. For example, the sun rises in the east. Number 5, the correct answer is A, economical. I think it will be difficult to find economical flights from now on. So we use the adjective economical when we want to describe something that saves our money. For example, economical cars or economical restaurants. On the other hand, we use the adjective economic when something is related to the economy of a country, area, or organization. For example, economic growth, policy, or crisis. Number 6, the correct answer is A, upbringing. My father didn't play a part in my upbringing. Let's look at the difference between upbringing and education. Upbringing is the way your parents and family teach you to behave when you're growing up, while education is something you receive at school or college. Number 7, the correct answer is B, relationship. I have a close relationship with my mom. So relationship means the way people feel and behave towards each other. And it can also mean a family connection. For example, what's her relationship to you? She's my niece. While relation means a relative. For example, he's a distant relation of mine. Number 8, the correct answer is B. How many of us are there? So when we talk about the number of people in a group, we have to say of us or of them. And when we answer, it's there are 8 of us. It's not correct to say we are 8. Be careful. Number 9, the correct answer is A. The company has bought 2 aircraft. So aircraft is an irregular plural. So we say 1 aircraft and 2 aircraft. We don't add an S. The same happens with other nouns like fish. 1 fish and 2 fish. Or more animals. 1 deer, 2 deer. Or 1 sheep, 2 sheep. Or 1 shrimp and 2 shrimp. And the last sentence, number 10, the correct answer is B, 4. You need to stand up for your beliefs. So the phrasal verb to stand up for something means to defend your beliefs, decisions, or principles. And there is also the phrasal verb to stand by your beliefs or decisions, which means to remain loyal to them and not change your mind. For example, she stood by her decisions. And guys, I've got a bonus sentence. She met her husband through A, common, or B, mutual friend. So choose A or B, and I'm going to give you the correct answer in our next English bit. So guys, that's it for today. I really hope you enjoyed this quiz and learned something new. Please share your score with me in the comments below. And I have another quiz on common mistakes at Kai. If you haven't seen it yet, you can find it right here. And of course, don't forget to like this lesson, to subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching and see you next week. Heading there. Ciao!